kids. In today's session, you are going to learn about the law of equimarginal utility. What is the meaning of the law of equimarginal utility? First, we'll see. Okay. The law of diminishing marginal utility is applicable only to the want of a single commodity. That one already I explained, isn't it? But our wants are, what I said, unlimited. Our wants are unlimited. It won't be satisfied. So we should analyze such a situation. The law of diminishing marginal utility is extended and it is called as a law of equimarginal utility. It is called also called as a law of the substitution. Okay. Next, we will already I said about the Gaussian's first law is the law of diminishing marginal utility. This one is the Gaussian's second law. Okay. Definition. What is the definition given? If a person has a thing which he can put to several uses, he will, what he will do there actually, it will distribute it among these uses in such a way that it has the same marginal utility in all. What they are saying, if a person has a thing which he can put to several uses, one of the thing we are having there, we are utilizing into the several ways there, okay. When we are utilizing in the several ways, he will distribute it among these uses in a such a way that it has the same marginal utility. What I said there, the marginal utility, it will be diminishing, isn't it? But what here they are saying, it will be having the same marginal utility. Okay. The, in this also we are having some assumption. Okay. Actually, here we are taking of the two commodities. According to the two commodities alone, we are discussing here. Okay. Actually, what the income we are having in our hand, according to that, we are deciding that what we should purchase, what we should consume there. Okay. Already in law of diminishing marginal utility, we talked about only the one thing, isn't it? But law of equimarginal utility, it will, we are discussing here, we can able to discuss here about the two or more things. Okay, that means already I told that human beings' wants are unlimited. So what we will do, if one product it's giving the maximum satisfaction to us, what we will do, we will move on to the another product. Okay, that only here also they given. That means how much product you can able to buy, that is called as a, with your income. Okay, with your income, how much product you can able to buy, how many products you can able to spend there. Okay, that is we are saying as a maximum utility. Here assumptions are given. Okay, the consumer is rational. The consumer is rational and he need the maximum satisfaction also. The utility of each commodity is measurable. Already I told, often we are used, that means we are measuring the utility in the cardinal number alone. The marginal utility of money remains constant. The money remains constant means what we are saying here, the income alone. The income, it will be remains constant. The income of the consumer already we are given. That only we are saying as a constant. Okay. There is a perfect competition in the market for the both product. There is a perfect competition. The prices of the commodity also already they given. That means we are assuming something to explain about the law of equimarginal utility. Okay. The law of diminishing marginal utility also it operates here. Okay. That means the marginal utility, it will diminish alone, but we are, what we are doing when it is diminishing, we are moving on to the another product also. Okay. Here they given about the explanation also. The law can be explained with the help of an example also they given, isn't it? That means they are taking here, a consumer is going to spend his limited income on the apple as well as on the orange. Okay, he is said to be in equilibrium when he gets maximum satisfaction. When he gets a maximum satisfaction with that income, if he received means with that commodities, then it is said to be that he achieved the equilibrium. That he achieved the equilibrium. Okay, that means what he is saying, when he is getting the equilibrium means marginality utility of one of the commodity. Okay, marginality utility of the commodity X by price of that commodity. it will be equal to the marginal utility of the commodity Y by price of the commodity Y equal to K. Okay, that K, it only we are saying as a equilibrium. K only we are saying as a equilibrium. What I explained, that alone I given here. See here, marginal utility of apple divided by price of apple, because we are taking the two commodity as a apple and orange. Okay, so marginal utility of apple by price of apple, it will be equal to marginal utility of orange divided by price of orange is equal to K. K, what I said, K is a equilibrium, I told, isn't it? That means K, if it is equilibrium, means we are getting the maximum satisfaction. The human being is getting the maximum satisfaction with the limited income. That means he can able to purchase two products. Okay. Through this example, I may say, okay, here we are taking the total income as 60. Okay, that means one of the person's income is 60. Price of apple is 10 and price of orange is 5. Okay, so it is one of the example only to know about the marginal, EQ marginal utility. Okay, next year units also I given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 units, up to 6 units we are going to buy. Marginal utility of apple for first unit when you are getting, that means purchasing, at that moment the person is getting the 100. The person is getting the marginal utility from the apple is 100. Okay. But in the marginal utility of orange, when he is purchasing one unit, he is getting only the 35. Only he is getting the 35. Like according to that alone, I given here. Okay. If he is receiving the 2 units of apple, means the marginal utility will be 90. Similarly, like that alone, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4, 80, 70, 60, 50. That means what I said, marginal utility, definitely it will decrease when you are increasing the units of the commodity. When we are increasing the units of the commodity, definitely the law of diminishing marginal utility, it will be applicable alone in this also. But what we are doing here, if we are not, that means when we are not having that much satisfaction in one of the product, we are moving to the next product, I said, isn't it? Yes, here same alone is buying, that means consuming one unit of orange is satisfaction is 35. That means the marginal utility is 35. And second one, when he is moving the 30, third one 25, for fourth one 20. Similarly, this also it declines alone. It also diminishing alone. Okay. From this, what we are calculating there, how much equilibrium that he is achieving. When he will achieve the equilibrium, that only we are calculating here. That only we are calculating through the MU by PA. MU, marginal utility of apple. Okay, marginal utility of apple by price of apple, one column, and another one, marginal utility of orange and price of orange in another column. Okay, here what we are doing, actually you know already, price of apple is 10, isn't it? Price of apple, it is 10. Okay, then marginal utility, what we are having here, 100. Okay, that means 100 by 10 equal to 10. Similarly, same like that, 90 by 10 equal to 9, 80 by 10 equal to 8, like that I have given here. Okay, and here the one of the price of orange is 5 rupees. Okay, that means 5 rupees means from the when we are having the marginal utility of orange, from that we may able to calculate the K here also. Okay, that means the equilibrium we may calculate here. That means 35 by 5 equal to 7. And 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, like that. Similarly, it will be, we are getting here. Here, what we should do, when he will get that achievement, that means the same achievement when he is getting here. That only we are going to see. That means when the person is taking 4 apples, he is getting the 7% equilibrium. Okay. When same 7% of equilibrium, when he is getting in the orange, means that means when he is utilizing only one orange itself, he is getting the 7% of satisfaction. Okay, here when he is getting the 4 apples alone, he is getting the 7% of satisfaction. But when he is purchasing the one apple, one orange itself, he is getting the 7% of the satisfaction. Okay, that means from his income alone we are calculating here. Next, when he is purchasing the 5 apples, that time he is getting the 6%. But when he is purchasing the 2 orange itself, he is getting the 6% of the satisfaction. Similarly, only I said here also, for the 6, the apple, for the apple, the equilibrium is 5. Here, for 3 itself, the equilibrium is 5. Okay. From this, we may calculate the marginal maximum utility. We may calculate the maximum utility when the person will achieve. We may, how we are actually, from where we should take here, actually from the 4 alone we should take, because from the 4 alone we can able to calculate. Before that, we are not having in the orange, isn't it? 10, 9, 8, we are not having in the orange. So what we are doing here, 4 apple, when is you are consuming 4 apple, okay, 4 apple, that means 4 apple means 4 apples cost is what, 4 into 10, 40 rupees, isn't it, plus 1 orange, when he is getting the 1 orange only, he is getting the same equilibrium there. That means when he is getting the 4 apple and 1 orange, he is getting the equilibrium, we are saying, isn't it? Whether it is the maximum utility or not, that only we are going to see. 1 orange into 5 equal to 5 rupees. That means the 45 rupees, which is lesser than his income. He is going to spend all of his income on that purchase. Okay, that means it is lesser than income. That means you won't get that much utility. You will get only the minimum utility alone. Next, we will move on to the 5 apple. Okay, 5 apple. That means 5 into 10 equal to 50 plus 2 oranges. That means 2 into 5 equal to 10. How much it's coming there? 50 plus 10, 60. That means what the income actually is receiving, 60 alone is receiving the income. That 60 income, he can able to utilize as it is in this one, isn't it? As it is in this one, when he is consuming the 5 apple and 2 orange, he can able to get the maximum utility. Okay, next we will move on to the 6th one, whether it will be possible or not. 6 apple, 6 apple means 6 into 10 equal to 60 plus 3 oranges, 3 into 5 equal to 15. How much we are getting there? 75. 75, which is very higher than his income. Which is very higher than his income, which he can't able to consume. Isn't it? He can't able to consume. That means a person can able to consume. That means he can able to get the maximum utility when a person is purchasing 5 apple and 2 orange. What we are saying here, through this example, we are explaining the law of EQ marginal utility. That means equal. When the marginal utility, it will be equalized. When it is equalized, when both we are comparing here in the tabular column, when we are both comparing here, through this alone, we can able to calculate the EQ marginal utility. Okay, EQ marginal utility only we are calculated here. Okay, this one is one of the example alone I am saying. Most probably, those who are giving the production to the market, that people alone, they will calculate about this one. How much that area people, they are getting income. Okay, how much they can able to spend on that product. How much they can able to spend on the product of one and another product. That means the product X and product Y. How much the people can able to spend through this law of EQ marginal utility alone, we may prove that one. Okay.